Have you ever considered to use Java or C Sharp into your game? Maybe you can imagine that you go to a site, let's say on Stack Overflow or on Quora, and there you will get the answer, you should use C++. And you are familiar with Java or with C Sharp, and you really think that you really care, for example, on the performance on C Sharp or of your game, which you have to have a big world or something like that, and you are really discouraged and you really want to scramble and to look into your C++ books. And in this article and comment, I will say why you kind of shouldn't, but maybe you would. And to start with the basics, I am a C++ developer, and I think languages are tools, but I will give probably a good reason why you shouldn't necessarily go right away to learn C++ if you want to make even a complicated game. Excluding you know very well how to use C++, which you probably wouldn't. So the Java, if you are familiar with Java or C Sharp, kind of all of them, they work the same. And the main idea is that as your program runs, part of the main, so let's say the main program runs 100% of the time, very likely only one method and some sub-methods out of it would be hot methods, the methods which they mostly execute most of the time. Maybe 1% or 2% of the full methods of your program will run, kind of 99% of the code. And all the others, the Java or say, .NET runtime, which they run the code, they will do some various levels of optimization and compiling. And Java in particular, it starts instead of having a simple compiler, which is typically named C1 compiler. It will start in an interpreted mode, and the methods which are kind of warm, they will be becoming C1 code, and this C1 code is executed the numbers of times, up to let's say 10,000 times, and after 10,000 times it's compiled in C2 code. And sometimes the C2 code becomes invalid. It is a longer discussion why. And it goes back to interpreter and recompiles again. So this cycle quite repeats up until the code gets very stable. And in this way, even the C2 compiler, it's a bit weaker, technically speaking, than a C++ compiler. It is not by that much than I think it will be conclusively shown. So I've looked on Quora, and in one particular response, it was given a very good sample, and that particular person was testing C++, and I have this code compiled with release mode using Visual Studio compiler. Even you see here, C-line is Visual Studio, and it runs really visibly faster. In that particular person testing, Visual Studio was exactly 6 times faster than C Sharp. So I have the code in C Sharp. Again, it is not that much important how the code works, but it gets many, many spheres. It uses the mathematical versions to see if they collide or not. And I also rewrote it with Java, and in the Java I did something a bit different, but we will talk. But also, in fact, I started from C Sharp doing something different. So the main part which a person who cares about performance would notice that when you make a class sphere, as you see, maybe you can see or not from the stream, this class is a separate memory on a separate memory address, and it has a cost just to visit the memory. And this will translate into lower performance because the processor will have to wait the CPU for the memory. And the code could be rewritten in a very simple form. In fact, it's quite similar as length. Maybe I wrote it more fluffy, but the code is basically 30 lines of code is the full associated code, maybe a bit less even if it's written more compact. So the code is not rewrite, it's the same algorithm and so on. And I will go directly to the numbers. And it's not too visible, but here the numbers I've got, they are a bit different. And this is normal because there are things like processors, turbo, cooling, and so on. But the very interesting part is that if you'll take the original implementation from whatever number of milliseconds to the default implementation, from in my exact case, the slowdown, it will be, in fact, 14 times, not only 6 times. But if it's rewritten as an array of doubles, which is a compact form in memory, the slowdown will go for 4 times. So I would assume the person will have the same kind of speed up, maybe not from 14 to 3, but let's say instead of 6 times, it will be 3 times slower. And if you use the .NET Core, the original implementation will be 4 times, 4.5 or something like that, times slower versus if you use, again, a compact version of memory, it's less than 3 times slower. But also, what's more interesting is that if it's rewritten in Java, because Java has a more aggressive compiler and it goes back to interpreter and so on, the cost it's 45% and it looks very bad. But I've seen variation, kind of, it goes from 20% to 50%, but I put the worst numbers to prove a point. So if you rewrite the code in Java, you'll have a 50% at most slowdown. And this number is very good, in fact, because if you have a game logic with 100,000 spheres or 50,000 spheres and they collide and they go that slow, probably the time which you'll spend to look into C++ and the bugs and a bit worse code completion and whatever logic you'll be missing, which is already provided with Java. In that time, you can do a better data structures. So for example, I'm not talking about the vector of doubles, but if the logic has many, many spheres, these spheres could be grouped. They could be split in some regions. So, and why it will be worth to be assigned to regions? It is simply that calculation, it's the complexity, if you know what is it, the order of magnitude, it's n squared. So for if you have 100,000 spheres, the code basically visits 100,000 multiplied by 100,000 spheres. So if you make regions, let's say 100 regions of 1,000 spheres, the full computation will be around 100 millions instead of more than my math. It may be dodgy, but otherwise, I think it will be 100 billion. So it's a order, it's 3 orders of magnitude faster if the algorithm could be rewritten. And with Java, you could do it easier. And reducing the expenses of computation by 1,000 times, it would make the code faster with Java, much more faster. Maybe not to 2 milliseconds, but let's say 20 milliseconds, which could be done almost in real time, which neither C++ or Java could do it. But on top of it, the Java can be rewritten as parallel, And I have also better scaling sometimes, but I use the worst time I had for scaling. So you could do the full processing in 250 milliseconds, so it's 8 times speed up, but sometimes I get 200 milliseconds here. But on a 12-core machine, and this is again very good, because you'll see that it's much faster than the C++ code. So if you'll have a game which has some logic with, let's say, many, many entities, and you do want to do a lot of processing on them, if you rewrite in Java, you have two options. It will be quicker to you to rewrite it in a more efficient data structure. And you'll have also the easiness to do it parallel. But some persons will say, look, you could rewrite it with OpenNP. And I did, in fact. So the code which you've seen it, I tried to use it OpenNP, and other code is not triggering it, or the optimizer, but I honestly could not make it OpenNP to work. And in Java, it was just simply adding as parallel. So you see here, we add the dot parallel line, and the code is running magically faster. So let's run it once again to show that. As I said, it was the biggest numbers. I couldn't get 150. Right now I have 191 milliseconds. So you could see that it's much faster than C++. Okay, so when you want to do Java or C++, do it first of all if you know it. Exactly why would you want to use Java or C++. But if you really want productivity and very good performance, I would say, especially if you have many entities, it's quite better to use Java or Kotlin for that matter, and start from there, and you can optimize it further. Thank you.